الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي الأمين. وبعد، the best of praise is to Allah, God Almighty, the creator and sustainer of the universe, and peace and blessings be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Give me a great pleasure to see, mashallah, this great number of people attending Islam convention. Tradition we've kept for decades because of many people have helped this organization to be where it is now. And I see many of them sitting here. From Dr. Saeed, Jamal Badawi, and others who are, I'm really standing on the shoulder now to speak to all of you. ISNA this year in Washington, D.C., have chosen the theme of this convention to be one nation under God, striving for common good. And for those who have heard me in Friday sermon of Jum'ah, I'm not going to repeat the Jum'ah because it'll take a long time. But the main point I'd like to make tonight, this is what this is a characteristic of our community. We believe in God and we serve others and we strive for common good. Extend our hand to anyone who like to join in bringing goodness and improving human conditions and serving our country. Many people have asked what ISNA does other than convention. I have spoken to someone from the other faith, a friend of ours, and he said to me, if we do nothing but convention, that's too much. Every year, we'll be able to put this together. I shared with them because the great volunteerism that we see in our community. About 400 people have volunteered this year to put this convention together. I want you to thank them. Serving all of us. ISNA have many programs, and you will be seeing some of this program in the video. I would like to mention a few of them. Our youth program, for example, have been reaching out to many young people. And having MSA president and MENA president to speak before me is by design. To show this convention is also about youth, young people. They are the future of this community. I have seen dedication and the devotion of young people to this beautiful religion of ours and to their country. That's why you see the scouting, Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, and the convention. But my brothers and sisters, I would like just to mention three, four points and I will leave the stage. But the importance of this gathering. We gather here today from all walk of life, very diverse community. We present a verse in the Quran where God Almighty says, O mankind, we have created you for male and female and made you two nations and tribes so that we might know one another. And the best among you are those who are the most righteous. This really convention represents that. You can look to the person next to you. You can see the people walking in the hall. You and you can see the diversity of ethnicity that enrich this Muslim community. My brothers and sisters, we're here to really to stand together to affirm our identity as Muslims. No matter what people say about us, what people might call us, we would like to today, from this stage, I would like to say to everyone that Muslim America, very proud to be Muslims, they are not really having a second thought about it, and also they're very proud to be the citizen of this country. And any questioning of this identity will not be accepted by these thousands of people here. That you might see in coming days, people will like to question who we are. Unfortunately, some people might use us during the political season also. But we would like to say that we as Muslims will stand for the values of serving humanity, reaching out to people, to be a compassionate community, a loving community, a caring community. And in that note, I would like to say that today that we have many people who are serving the larger community by establishing community clinics across America. Muslims, physicians, and doctors who are doing health care in this convention. Tomorrow, matter of fact, they will be doing a blood drive for all of you to come and to donate blood. And I was given the room, maybe we'll ask the Brother Asra just to mention it again later. But that's what we stand for. We are a community that gives, that community that cares, community that reach out to the larger community to work with them in common good. Second point I would like to make. During difficult times, Muslims have been attacked, Quran threatened to be burned, or somebody have burned it. And the issue of building mosques, interfaith community, people of other faiths, they come and stood shoulder to shoulder with Muslims. And there's a birth of an organization called Shoulder to Shoulder of 28 religious groups leading people of faith, leaders, people of faith have come together with the Muslim community to say that we will not accept bigotry and hate directed toward Muslims. Because they said, attack on only one religion is attack on all religion. This America that we know, that America that we love, that we know the people of conscience will not allow the attack on this beautiful community of ours. ISNA have helped give birth to this organization. Third point, that many people ask us to do more things. Say, I wish you could do this, I wish you could do that. And I would like to tell you, my brothers and sisters, that we will welcome any idea of yours. ISNA is your organization. We would like to feedback. We would like you to become a member of ISNA. We would like you to participate in ISNA activities. And we would like you also to support ISNA as an organization. Do you know $42 million have been spent last year, the year before, to attack this community? Fear Inc. report, $42 million. My brothers and sisters, we have to spend $42 million spreading good, helping others, building community clinics, soup kitchens, because that's how we respond. وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ اتْبَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ. Respond with what is good. That would be our gift to America. We raise money to help all community, to help all people, because we do not respond with hate. We do not respond with bigotry, because we are loving and caring community. I would like to recognize my friend Karen Armstrong, who is sitting here, for helping us, inspiring us to establish the community of compassion. She's been traveling from city to city, spreading the idea of the Committee of Compassion, I would like to announce to you that ISNA is leading an effort to establish curriculum and the guidelines of establishing masajid that really defines it as a compassionate masjid and compassionate schools, because that's what we stand for. We stand for the values and the principle that taught by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah said to him, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have sent you for no other purpose except to be a mercy to the world. And in that note, that Muslims believe that the message of Islam is a message of peace, it's a message of respect for human life. I know in the anniversary of 9/11, which is coming soon, we'll hear people again decide what Muslims stand for. I would like to tell them, we stand for protecting human life, we stand for rejecting any innocent life, and when the anniversary of 9/11 comes, we will serve people. We will be there as have been a community of reaching out to our neighbors and working with others. In conclusion, when the Imam says in conclusion, don't look to your watch. Because sometimes it's a conclusion. I would like to recognize some people who have helped us to make this a possible, a convention. Convention Steering Committee. More than 100 volunteers, as I mentioned earlier. The sponsor, many people have sponsored this convention. And the vendors, by the way, do shopping, please, go and shop. Help the vendors who have helped to support this organization. And the convention speakers. We have so many wonderful speakers who have contributed tremendously to our enriching this convention. And I would like to thank you, the attendees, for being here today. And also would like to recognize Dr. Muhammad Jawad, a doctor featured in the movie Saving Face. Face. I did not mispronounce it. Face, not face. Is the plastic surgeon doctor. Now, I would like to introduce one of our main speakers today. But before I do that, I would like to thank Muslims who are serving in the government. Muslims are public servants, and to thank all the public servants, especially our fellow Muslims. And among them is my friend, my brother, Mazen Basra. who served in the Department of Justice. Mazen has been a great example and model for our public servants, who is proud of his identity as Muslims and American. Now, I would like to introduce you to you, a friend of the community, who are working in the issue of civil rights with passion. And we as Muslim community, before I have been on the stage, we are worried about civil rights issues. Worried about the issue of profiling, the issue of the New York police and others who are really disturbed. Those issues have disturbed us tremendously. And the issue of training, law enforcement. Those are the issues that have been working with the law enforcement and government to speak truthfully, openly, and we disagree with them when we need to disagree, and we thank them when they do the right thing. But I would like to introduce you today to a person who really believes in the issue of civil rights and has passion for it, our friend Tom Praise, who is Assistant Attorney General of Civil Rights Commission.